Got
Hello,
it.
vampire maniacs out there. It is your host from the most, Benjamin Dutille, with the Horror Heathen YouTube channel and the South Jersey Horror Podcast. Today, I am super happy. I have a very special guest today, Miss Natalie Brown, who plays Kelly Goodweather in one of my all-time favorite shows on FX, The Strain. Not
Hi.
many people know this, but, oh, hi.
Hi.
Not enough people know that The Strain is based on a comic book slash book, which I need to go buy the books so I can read. I did the reverse process. I watched the movie, then I'm gonna watch the show, then I'm gonna read the comics. But you're supposed to read the books before you watch the movie, so shame on me.
In complete reverse order, that's okay.
Okay.
Once you go and read the trilogy of books, then you can tell me how you felt about the ending. Just saying.
So thank you for joining me today. I am super happy that you agreed to do this. I am super stoked. I jumped for joy when I got the email. I really did. I giggled
Aww.
like a little schoolgirl, just saying. So,
well, thank you for reaching out. I mean, what a great way to start the new year, besides the fact that I'm a little under the weather, but I think a lot less worse off than a lot of people were this holiday sickness season. So thanks for having me. Nice to meet you. Happy New Year.
And you are my very first guest of the year. So congratulations. So
Yay.
This is fantastic.
Go on.
So if you could please provide a brief background about yourself.
Well, you know my name. I'm based up in Canada. I currently live in Toronto, Ontario, and I'm from a little mining town named Timmins. It's not even a town, it's a city. It's a great mining city that Shania Twain's from. You might be familiar with her, being from the South. So she's our claim to fame, Shania and a lot of hockey players. I went to high school there. I graduated. I spent some time traveling through Asia, doing a little bit of modeling, traveling, learning. I studied some fine arts at York University in Toronto. And I've been doing commercials for a long time since I was like a teenager. And I had like an event company going for a little bit, and I finally wanted to put all my eggs in one basket. So I'd already become a union member, a proud actor member, but I'd never really acted. I'd done a ton of commercials and then finally started to study the craft. And my very first line in a movie was How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days. But my very first feature film that I starred in was a vampire movie with David Carradine, may he rest in peace, called The Last Sect. And I just spent New Year's Eve with a cinematographer. So we had all kinds of great stories about that first experience. The Last Sect, it was like a loose homage to The Hunger.
Okay.
And I guess that was maybe the beginning, because I have to be honest, it's not that I'm not a fan of horror, it's that I'm very affected by it. So I don't particularly like watching horror, but I just keep working in it. And I've worked with some great creators of the genre, like the very, very best. Guillermo, obviously being Mr. Del Toro, being one of the maestros of the genre. And I also did one of the first all-female horror anthologies, starring, written by, produced by, directed by women, called XX. And that was directed by Jovanka Vukovic, who was the first female editor of Rumorg magazine. And so they've given me books on horror. I'm still trying to, like, you know, figure out my relationship with horror. But I've had some incredible experiences working within the genre.
I love it. I mean, horror is my thing, and obviously it's yours too.
Teach
so
me
I
ways.
mean Back in 2016, or when The Strain came out, I was super. I saw the previews for it. I was like, "This is gonna be an amazing show." I
Because
mean,
you already knew the comic books or the graphic
no, I
novel.
didn't know. I did not.
You knew
Believe it or not, I
Guillermo
did
del
not.
Toro, and you were like,
Oh
"Yes,
yeah, of course."
please." Right. Yeah, that
And
was his
Chuck
first
Hogan, who's the really good
oriented
part too.
television. Chuck Hogan, yeah.
Yes, I saw the
Yeah.
preview. I was like, and I was heartbroken. There was just four seasons. I was like, they have to do more with this. But I understand why they cut off of four seasons, because a lot of TV shows are drug on. It's like 20, 25, 30 seasons. They ended
Yeah.
at four. I understand why they did it. I'm not happy with it, but I understand why.
I feel the
So,
same. I feel the same.
and you have a few awards that are very, very noteworthy here. 2016, you won Best Actress in a TV Series broadcasted in the U.S. for The Strain at the Gold Maple Awards. Congratulations. Could you Kelly Goodweather, you nailed it. It is perfectly done. Phenomenal job playing her.
Well, they sent me to vamp camp, and I grew up with loving but strict parents who wouldn't let me go to camp. So the first time I was finally able to go to camp was starting with an incredible choreographer, Roberto Campanella, who has worked with Guillermo many times, and he's like a movement coach and choreographer with his own contemporary dance company. But yeah, he brought all the people playing vampires to vamp camp. So he taught us sort of movement training and to give some kind of synergy to how the vampires moved. And when I finally started to get the like early vamp stage sort of 1 through 4 twitches going, then they're like, no. Okay, enough with the twitching. Now you are a more sentient vampire. Now that the master has granted you, a few more abilities, a limited palette, I was told, but a little bit more emotional range. So I had to stop the twitching and try to find that fine line, with a little bit of access to some humanity, enough to kind of connect with my son Zach, not in the way that I wanted, of course, because all any vampire wants to do is turn their loved ones. It's an act of love, by the way. So becoming a vampire was the best worst thing to happen, Kelly. It was
We
the
did
worst thing
such
to
a.
happen, Kelly. It was the best thing to happen to me as an actor.
We
It was
just you just did a paramount job. I mean, listen, Kelly Goodweather is actually one of my favorite characters in the show, along with who'd Sean Astin play? I can't remember his character's name. I'm a huge disappointment right now.
Oh my gosh, because he died so horribly in season 1. Sean Astin.
Sean Astin, yes, I forgot his character's name, but
I can't
that was
remember.
sad.
Yeah.
Getting shot by, I don't know, Kevin Durant just it kind of threw me off a little bit.
I mean, it's a good way. If you gotta go down, let it be by Kevin Durant, who was amazing. I had one fight scene with Fett, which was, oh yeah, bringing back all the memories. I pulled up my favorite mug too. This is like one piece of fan art that someone drew of me. A lot of people when they get fan art, they're like, really beautiful
Yeah.
drawings. And mine was poor Kelly in that like that sort of prolific puke stained sweater and the bloody neck gyna that all the vamps sported. You said it's 19 plus, 18 plus, so I guess we can say
Yeah,
thank you, neck gyna.
absolutely. I don't
You're
care.
almost
Go for
there, not mine. Maybe it was hair and makeup. Yeah.
Kevin Durant's one of for Silly Fett is one of my other favorite characters. His humor in the show is fantastic.
He's so great. He's also a fellow Canadian from Northern Ontario. He's from 8 hours further north than I am. He's from Thunder Bay.
Oh,
I'm from
wow.
Timmins. So it was great. And actually, an assistant that was working for Guillermo was also from Timmins, Ontario. And it's like, how did three kids from Northern Ontario all end up getting to work with Guillermo? It was pretty great. And Carlton Cuse, too, who was our showrunner, head writer, and actually directed the finale of the show. Miles Dale, who is the producer and went on to direct some of my favorite episodes in The Strain also, and then won the Oscar with Guillermo for Shape of Water. So we had quite the team of incredible geniuses at the helm.
A lot of good actors coming out of Canada. I'm not gonna lie. I mean,
We got a few. We got a few.
I've interviewed a lot of actors and actresses that live in Canada, and I feel like they got the talent. You've got the faces for it, that's for sure. I mean, it's charisma is what it is, and I love it. So it's
Don't take
fantastic.
ourselves too seriously. Most of us. You've got a Seth Rogen vibe. I'm not gonna lie. Another great Canadian with a great sense of humor and a lot of talent. I don't know if you've got
I appreciate
that
that.
before.
So, speaking of horror anthologies, from going from being human to being bitten in the strain, frequently finding yourself surrounded by werewolves, zombies, and vampires, and killers, oh my, with your background of acting in horror, what seems to draw you in into horror? Because you said you don't like it, but you're drawn into it.
They say what you resist persists. So there might be something to that. I grew up on Elm Street and was plagued by a recurring nightmare.
Oh,
So
wow.
like Nightmare on Elm Street was like my life. Like the nightmare was of a completely different nature. It was like a moose monster that was coming for me in the basement. And my partner actually gave me a book similar to one that Jovanka had given me called it was like The Psychology of Fable. And it talks about like, you look at the early fairy tales, they were, Grimm's fairy tales were pretty grim. Cannibalism and you know, all kinds of things to scare the crap out of kids. But they say that it's a safe way, both in reading books and watching horror movies, is a safe way, or at least Fable was a safe way for children to exorcise their deepest unconscious feelings in a safe space. And the thing is, I think because I was plagued by nightmares, and I do believe in evil, and I do believe in the paranormal, I don't find it entertaining.
Right.
I just think it's
Absolutely. I get it. Yeah.
possible. And I kind of tend to want to spend my life like avoiding those feelings of anxiety. But maybe some, I think fear is processed in the amygdala. I think that's what one of the books said. And so is joy. So there's a fine line between joy and fear. And maybe my line is thicker. I don't know. But I like to avoid feelings of fear and anxiety. I don't get pleasure out of it. But what I do get pleasure out of is the writing and the people that I get to work with. I also worked on a horror movie called The Breach. If you like classic horror, it was executive produced by Slash. There's a fellow horror lover. And working with the director, Rodrigo Godino, and just some of the great minds that are interested in the genre. I don't know. I love the opportunity to work with these kinds of minds.
Yeah, I, for some reason, I am drawn to the macabre. Don't know why. I always
Tell
have
me.
Been.
You have to guess why.
You see the posters behind me.
I do. They're already scaring me. Like, so, I mean, the thought of like, I don't know, as a woman too, like the thought of like a man like in a mask chasing me through the woods, like it literally is your worst nightmare. So
like my kids are constantly begging for a pool, and I just keep showing them the movie Poltergeist.
How old are they?
19 and 18. So,
oh,
yeah.
Okay. Well, I have a story for you. I don't know if this is on your list. Is the show Channel Zero, Candle Cove, the first season?
Yes.
Did you enjoy that series?
I did. It was the creepy tooth guy scared the shit out of me. Not gonna lie.
The tooth child is one, again, like, I think that's just such a creative genius thing to come up with all out of Nick and Tosca's brain. He's gone on to do such great things. It was really kind of, I don't know if this is the right term, but it was like highbrow horror for me. And I was a little disturbed when I found out how, I don't want to spoil anything, but how things went for my character, I'll say. And we were working with some incredible kids, some child actors, and the material was so dark and so scary that I asked some of the parents if they let the kids read the script. And one of the girls who also plays, she plays a little girl, and then she's also possessed by a 12-year-old demon boy. And the parents are like, oh yeah, she believes in ghosts and she loved the script and she gets it. Like, and so she would go from talking about like strawberry waffles, and then they would yell rolling, and then her head would drop. Her eyes would sink, her voice would drop like three octaves, and she just knew when she was playing possessed by a 12-year-old boy. And it was shocking to me. So I go into the lunchroom where all the kids are waiting to eat lunch. And I was told that these kids weren't gonna act out a scene as garishly and as gruesome as the scene was written. And as soon as I walked into the lunchroom, they all grabbed their cutlery and pointed their knives at me and were totally looking at me. And it's like, they know exactly what it's about. And I don't know, maybe they're just less afraid than I am. Maybe the fear just comes with age. I don't know.
Well, speaking of kids, I have to know, in the TV show The Strain, Kelly's love for Zach is immeasurable. We all see that. It's all exhibited through the entire series. How frustrated we were every time we got close to Zach. How do you think Kelly would feel every time she got close to Zach and he'd slip away?
Oh, wow. I love that. Just a sip away. Is that what you said?
Yes. It's like, you're saying, she's like, back here.
Just a sip away. Well, it's funny because going into, I think it was season three, where I was that like spending all the time with Zach and the sewers, and I chorused incredible Richard Sammo, my favorite character. So thrilled I got to work so closely with him. I had been like given like a free juice cleanse trial. And I kind of was hating on the idea of it, but I hadn't tried it. I thought, before I knock it, I gotta try it. And I did it. It was only 3 days, but I felt such intense longing, craving, and to even watch my partner eat a carrot, I just was like, kind of wanted to kill him,
Like,
consume carrot. Like, it was like a longing and lusting I'd never felt. And I thought, this is exactly what Kelly is going to have to go through. Just this intense longing for something that is like right there, but she can't have. So I decided to do another juice cleanse on set. And it went horribly wrong. I just was hangry and frustrated. And luckily, Kelly didn't have a lot of lines. You know, she mostly just sort of said, Zach. Zach, and I let the feelers do all the hard work for me.
yeah, those feelers creep me out. I think I had nightmares about those feelers.
Really? But
Yeah.
see, to me, they're fantastical. Like, I know feelers don't exist, so they don't actually scare me.
Yeah.
And they were some of the most incredibly gifted acrobats that played the feelers. And we'd be, you know, it was a lot of night shoots and a lot of cold winters in Toronto shooting at night. But we all kept warm together. And like I said, they did all the hard work for me. Like Kelly just had to like hit her mark, say Zach a couple of times, and let the females do all of Kelly's grunt work. It was just a really fun season.
So if I was doing the juice cleanse, I'd drop kick someone for a carrot. I would.
Yeah. So I kind of used that kind of frustration and longing when it came to Zach. Because,
Body
and
slam. I don't
also,
care.
like in her defense, that's an act of love, right? It's what you want to do. Also, like the world's gone to shit in the story. I have the gift of everlasting life. So, of course, I want to bring my most beloved to my side.
Yeah. I mean, I'm sorry. I'm watching. It's so frustrating. You're getting so close every time to him, and then Ephraim comes in and just fucks everything up for you. It's like, God damn it!
Just like an ex-husband does. Not that I know.
This is great. I love this. So, the sister boy, or like a more like an old country European Ukrainian weird Heinz 57 bullshit going on. I don't know.
Who's
This
that,
is
sir?
still weird. What's that?
Who's that?
So I call the Strigoi a Heinz 57
Oh,
vampire. So,
gotcha. The Strigoi. Yes. They were not vampires. They were just Strigoi.
what is your favorite rendition? Like, fangy vampire, rah, stinger coming out vampire.
I know that Guillermo very specifically set out to put an end to the idea that vampires are these sparkly faced, you know, dudes with romantic problems. Not going to name any names.
Blasphemy! Blasphemy!
Yeah, they're like vile creatures to be feared, and he made sure that we were like as vile looking as possible. And I don't know that I have any like opinion on it. I know that I asked him when we were shooting the pilot for The Strain. It happened to fall on Guillermo's like 50th birthday. And so we had this like great lunch right next door at this famous steakhouse. It's a keg. It's like the keg restaurant, but it's in what is thought to be a haunted mansion. It's called Keg Mansion. And a few people have died on the premises, and he thought that was pretty cool. And I asked him, do you believe in ghosts? And he was like, yes. I think he was going on like a ghost tour in New Orleans or something for his birthday. Don't quote me on anything. My memory's horrible. I get it all wrong. But it's never bad. It's always better. I only embellish for the best. And well, then I said, and so if there's so much folklore on vampires from so many different cultures for so many different centuries, like, is there any truth to it? He was like, ghosts, yes. Vampires, no. Which is maybe
Really?
why I enjoy working in that. In that particular genre, because I know that it's fantasy
Right,
and
right.
allegorical, heavily allegorical. Like you'll find in the books, I believe he said, or maybe it was Chuck Hogan. And I love, you're gonna love the writing. Still one of my favorite lines in a book, I think Chuck Hogan wrote. But the first book is biological, the second book is sociological, and the third book is mythological.
Okay.
And another
Yeah.
fun fact, I think, I hope I didn't get this wrong, but I remember Carlton Cuse telling me that you could actually get a credit at, I think, Berkeley University in the strain biology
Really?
because it was based in, obviously,
Interesting.
there's no such thing as vampirism, but they based it in a lot of biological fact,
Right.
just to make it as, you know, realistic as possible, and you could actually get a credit.
Yeah, I gotta check that out. I really gotta check that out because I'm into that kind of stuff.
Further
So,
your education.
master's degree in criminal justice, just not good enough anymore. So,
Gotta get that extra credit.
of all the people who played the master in a movie, who is your favorite one?
Yeah, like who played the actors that played the master in The Strain?
Yes.
Well, Roger Maillet, sorry, Robert Maillet played the master, and he was just such a wonderful human being. Just like the gentlest giant with the biggest shoes, the biggest New Balance I've ever seen. And he's just such a great actor and a lovely, lovely man. And then the incredible Jonathan Hyde took over, who was great. And he was like, oh, it's so frustrating. Do you have any? I don't know if he asked me for tips. Maybe I just gave him unsolicited tips. But I said, just imagine every impulse you've ever had as an actor and then sitting on it and not able to play it. It just sort of makes you vibrate with like this intense frustration where it's like, you're a little more monosyllabic and, a little bit more streamlined with your intentions. And I personally thought if you wanted to break away from the books, I thought Kelly would have been a good master to sing.
So speaking of Robert May, he spoiler alert, he is coming on my show sometime this month. So
Another amazing Canadian on the East Coast.
I was his publisher reached out to me and said he would come on the show, and not until he finds out what his schedule's like for this month. I was like, that is fine, take your time. I understand actors or have personal lives too, so
Yeah,
I can't get them
I think
all.
he's a grandpa now.
So yeah. I'm supposed to reach out to his publicist sometime next week to get his schedule.
All
So I'm
right.
super excited to get him too because he. I was like, dude, I've got to get someone from The Strain on my show. Except at first, I thought about you, Robert Murray. I thought about Corey Stoll. I thought about Sean Astin. Everybody, all the main characters, Kevin Durant. What's your name? Ritima Gimentis. Yeah,
Yeah.
I tried to get everybody. So anyway, coming down to the
Richard
third last.
Semmel, Mia Maestro.
Mir Meister
Richard
reached out
Semmel.
as well. So,
Yeah, me and Richard would be a great guest too.
yeah, I'm actually following them on, they're following me on social media, which is great. So, I'm going down to the last 4 minutes of those questions. You've been fa a fantastic guest. I really appreciate you doing this for me. I've had a lot of fun
Was so
talking
much
to
fun because it's been 10 years. I
you.
can't believe I'm saying that. It makes me sad in a way that so much time has passed because it still feels so fresh and the show is still available. But it was 2013. We initially shot a very frigid pilot in the winter of in Toronto. Yeah.
Well, I was hooked on the first episode. The pilot episode's got me reeled in. I was
So
like, I
good.
cannot wait. And it's every time a new season come out, I just get way too excited. But I wait for all the episodes to come out so I can watch them back to back, back to back, instead of like once a week. So
Right.
yeah.
Yeah. It's better that way.
And then like a few months ago, last month I was like, I'm gonna watch The Strain again. Fuck it. I like the show, I'm gonna watch it again for the fifth time. So
The fifth time. Oh my
all
goodness.
right.
You are wow. You could probably fill in many of the gaps I have. But it's all coming back to me. So it's nice. I'm grateful for the refresher and for the questions. They're great.
So, are there any upcoming projects that, like Baby Daddy and Widow Seduced, are you allowed to talk about those, like, so I can help promote on social media for you?
Baby Daddy is a working title, and it is actually the first show that I have co-written and co-produced with my wonderful writing partner and great friend Lisa Barry. Lisa Barry, you might know from Supernatural. She plays Billy the Reaper slash Death. And so, yeah, we've created it's like a flipped world male fertility comedy that we're currently pitching. And so maybe that's all I can say about that. But having a ton of fun, and that is an entirely new experience for me, and having a really good time with that. And A Widow Seduced, I believe, is coming out. We shot that a year ago, and it's a lifetime thriller. It was called A Dangerous Romance, but new title is, yeah, A Widow Seduced. That'll be coming out, I believe, in February on Lifetime. And I've shot another couple of thrillers with some great directors. One is called Smart Home Killer. It actually just premiered on Lifetime. We just haven't seen it in Canada yet, directed by the wonderful Michelle Neal. And I just shot a thriller in Kelowna, BC with Monica Mitchell. It's literally the last thing I did a few weeks ago, and I'm trying to remember what the title is. Ask me one more time, and I'll come back to that in a second.
So I have a
Absolutely.
favor to ask you. And
Yeah.
a friend of mine, her name's Holly, said she loved you in The Strain. You were her favorite
Oh.
character in the entire show. So I was wondering if you could just say hello, hi to her real quick. Just she
Of
asked me, so.
course. Of course, of course, of course. Oh, like I thought she was gonna pop on live.
Oh, no. This would I
Oh,
wish she
okay.
was here, really did better.
Oh, Holly, I wish you were here. Just wanted to say Happy New Year to you. Thank you for watching The Strain. It's a great show. And thanks for keeping the love alive.
Thank you so much. She's gonna love that so much. That's all I have. Thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate you coming on the show.
Thank you for having me. Any
I had a
recos?
fantastic time.
Any of your favorite new horror titles that you might recommend for a lightweight like me?
A lightweight. How about Five Nights at Freddy's? Have you seen it or
Okay,
not?
that sounds fun.
It's PG-13. It's aimed more for like the children audience, which I got my kids onto, so they love it. So that does give them nightmares.
Okay, yeah,
So.
just that's all we strive for. It's just good sleep. Yeah. All right.
Ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, vampire vamps and fiends alike, the beautiful, the talented, the most awesome actress in The Strain, Natalie Brown, thank you so much. I wish you nothing but the best of your career, and I will see you on the big screen.
Thank you. Remember, Kelly loves you.
And your blood. No, I'm just kidding.
Your blood.
Thank you
Happy
so
New
much.
Year. All
Happy New
right.
Year to you.
Thanks so much. Bye. Wake up, we got another day to